Let's talk about other difficult conundrums, and that's how we bring Russia in from the cold. Well, they've been trying that for decades, haven't they? But will Joe Biden, the US president, finally succeed? Well, question marks over that. He's meeting for a summit with Vladimir Putin, the Russian president, in Geneva later today. But what can we expect to come of this meeting? Let's talk to Dr. Jade McGlynn, who's the director of research at the Henry Jackson Society and expert on Russian affairs. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Julia.
How much should we expect to come out of this summit between these two men? Of course, met before when Joe Biden, of course, was a vice president under Obama. But what's on the agenda and what's likely to be achieved?
I think first, it's safe to say that hopes have never been lower for what might come out of this summit. In terms of what's on the agenda, be Russian sort of cyber attacks, disinformation, trying to suss out each other's red lines to the extent that that's possible. And maybe the best thing that is likely to come out of it will be a return of normality to the diplomatic missions, because neither the US ambassador nor the Russian ambassador are actually in place at the moment. So that feels like...
Yes, that makes life a bit more difficult. I mean, look, we've had this bizarre situation where, you know, Vladimir Putin has been accused of meddling in American elections. There's question marks of whether there was some sort of weird deal with Donald Trump, where, you know, Vladimir Putin's, you know, getting praise from Donald Trump over his own security services in terms of meddling with the election. Cyber warfare allegations against the Russians as well. But also Russian expansionism, and what they've been, their involvement in Syria. There are so many big issues on the table, quite apart from the whole, you know, murdering opposition and imprisoning opposition leaders, and indeed murdering people on the streets of Britain with impunity as well. Is there a route to bring Russia over to the West, to bring Putin in particular onto the same sort of the same group of nations as the West? Or is that just pie in the sky stuff?
I think that's complete pie in the sky if it comes to Putin in particular. I actually do think that what Biden should do is to focus on Russia, not Putin.
Yeah.
So actually, you know, America and the UK, for what it's worth, in Russia, many Russians have a much more positive view of the US and UK than you would expect, particularly young Russians. And I think maybe try and send a message to them through the summit, because Putin probably won't live forever. Probably.
I don't know. I wouldn't put it past him. I mean, somewhere on this secret island under the sea where he's stroking his white cat, I'm sure he's got some sort of potion to keep him alive forever.
They do say, actually, and it's a rumour, but they do say in the Kremlin they're very obsessed with, you know, what's it called, cryogenics, when you freeze.
But you're saying that there is some hope, sort of, but again, only once Putin's gone. But Putin's never going to relinquish power on his own. I mean, this is the thing. And I do worry that Joe Biden has not necessarily got all of his faculties there. And Vladimir Putin is a slippery character and a very, very, very clever, ruthless man. And one, I suppose, quite worried that he will run rings around Joe Biden today.
I think Biden is very well counseled. You know, the people that Biden has around him, they are really excellent advisors. So, and I mean, of course, Biden is older, but with that also comes the fact that, you know, he's been around the block for a while. He's used to Putin. He is likely to know the obvious tricks that Putin plays. But as you say, Putin is a very shrewd operator, which is why I think that on the US side, they've been right to really dampen expectations, because I don't think that there's not going to be a major reset, and nor should there be, because a reset can only come from Russia's side, because it's Russia who's, you know, as long lived.
Well, we shall wait and see what happens. Thank you very much, Dr. Jade McGlynn from the Henry Jackson Society. Thank